Hi everyone, my name is Aya Yamani and I'm the Talent and Group Ambassador. I'm here today with Rabia Jrej, Head of Chanel Fragrances and Beauty. I'm also here with Loujain Elbarghouti, Commercial Manager for L'Occitane, and Joseph Chalhoub, Operations Manager for Beauty Franchise. We are tuning in from Jeddah. And what an exciting time to be living through Saudi Arabia's transformation under the leadership of His Royal Highness King Salman and the Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman, as governed by the Vision 2030, which consists of three key pillars. The first one being a vital and vibrant society with strong values, taking pride in our national identity while empowering our society and leading fulfilling lives. This pillar promotes culture and entertainment, wellness, and achieving environmental sustainability. The second pillar, a thriving economy, is based on continued investments in education and training so that our youth are equipped for the jobs of the future. It also focuses on boosting our small businesses while putting forward an economy that is open for business, by improving the business environment, establishing special zones, and maximizing our investment capabilities. The third pillar, also known as an ambitious nation, is all about being responsible. Responsible in our lives, in business, and in society. It gives life to an ambitious nation, effectively governed by embracing transparency, and engaging everyone. The country is going through a massive transformation journey. And with the recent changes in society, we notice that affluent Saudis are now willing to vacation in Saudi and spend locally. We also recognize the efforts in improving the ease of doing business through the creation of a variety of associations that really aim in bringing the public and private sectors closer to one another. So, Rabia, how do you think the consumer is changing nowadays?
Hi, Aya. Hi, Joe. Hi, Loujain. Thank you, Aya, for these questions. Today, the speed at which the environment around us is moving has increased drastically. The impact on us as individuals working in retail and customer service is to adapt to the speed in order to stay ahead. The customer's needs today and wants, they are changing. They are changing and the expectations are becoming so high. Customers are now, they are more demanding. They are more exposed. They know what do they want. They just want to be delighted. Okay, so I think in our business, everything evolved around customer centricity and treating each customer and individual as individual. So we have to give them the comfort to shop, whether they are in our stores or in our online retail business. Today, if we want to zoom in a little bit about the experience in Saudi Arabia, the experience in Saudi Arabia has a big room for improvement, especially that Saudi Arabia today will be exposed to the world. And our mission as leading this business industry is to raise the bar in our services, whether we are in our stores or outside our stores or on the online business, especially with the rise of e-commerce during the pandemic situation. We have really to bridge the online and the offline business together. We have to deliver the same experience whether it is online or online.
Thanks for your inputs, Rabia. Adding on to that, I'd love to know from Loujain, can you please elaborate further on the emergence of the new women's purchasing power in KSA?
Thank you, Aya. Thank you, Rabia. Indeed, those changes made a huge impact on our consumers' behavior. And that was purely the result of our King's vision, where he mainly wants us to go back to the real Islam and culture when women took leadership roles in a lot of instances and was empowered to participate in various roles of the community. These changes are an opportunity to encourage Saudi women, starting from our own employees to our shoppers, to be stronger, louder, braver, and more independent. It fosters enormous financial, political, and social changes, which will lead her help sharing responsibilities and improve the quality of life of the entire family. Therefore, it is something for all of us to celebrate this emergence of the new women's purchase power, where it will be nature shift her preferences, so does her taste. Also, if I may, one of the key points of the vision is to reduce the unemployment rate for Saudi citizens 9% and to reach 28% females by 2030, participation in the workforce. Where I proudly say that at Chalhoub Group, we stand at 70% females, 13 females in managerial levels. All of that gives us a powerful, solid perception and an indication of the shift in our guests' behavior that that was witnessed in the past couple of years. Whether from seeing our guests coming themselves rather than sending their drivers to pick up their orders, which eventually reflected on our sales driven by our experienced staff in cross-selling, or even in the slight increase in the travel size products after the abolishment of the legal guardian. I hope that answered your question, Aya.
Oh, definitely. Thank you, Lejeune. That was quite insightful. And it's nice to also see, what the group is doing in that sense. So with everything that the government's doing and, keeping the tourist influx in mind, there's many opportunities for growth. We would love to know, Joseph, your thoughts on how we as Chalhoub Group are accelerating our efforts in line with the Vision 2030.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. The Chalhoub Group is actively positioning itself as a key partner for Vision 2030 across all the three pillars, starting with a vibrating society. While the Saudi leadership started the very impressive transformation on the social level, our group was undergoing an internal shift by digitalizing its activities, being more agile in the way we operate, and accelerating the decision-making process. On the pillar, a thriving economy, the group is strengthening its footprint in the Saudi market by bringing in more international brands. After being a leader in the beauty industry for the past few decades, a task force is currently put in place to bring in more fashion brands and help them expand across the kingdom. And finally, an ambitious nation. Even though our group is doing well on Saudization and we are achieving our objectives, we will be pursuing the journey to find the young Saudi talents, sponsor and groom them so that they are ready to take over key and strategic positions in the near future.
Thank you, Joseph. I think we can all agree that the past few months have been a learning experience for many of us. So what were your biggest challenges during the pandemic?
Well, if you allow me to start, I think safety and keeping employee and customers safe was our top priority during this phase. Protecting people who are at higher risk was very crucial for us. Taking care of our employees, taking care of our clients was our main priority. And as well abiding by the safety regulation that the government has already put. It was really, really, I can say that it was positive in terms of taking care of the health of the people, yet it had some negative impact on the business, but it is a temporary impact because during this phase, we have learned a lot. We have learned that managing risk should be part of our all-time strategic planning. So we were planning for everything, but we have never planned that the entire world will be under confinement. So I think this should be a big learning for every single business, in, whether it was in retail or whether it was in food and beverage or any other businesses. So again, people, they are the key business drivers. Keeping them safe, ensuring that they are very well and they are at all time staying in their home if they are feeling unwell, and making sure that the other people that they are feeling well, they are attending and supporting the business. This was key for us during this pandemic.
Indeed, Rabia, if I may jump in, talking about our people, the team have showed amazing resilience to this tough situation. And more than ever, the energy of the family and the team spirit was inspiring. The most important element was protecting the well-being of our team members, as Rabia said. And despite all the challenges, for example, Saned, let's say, we saw the level of dedication and loyalty, which has proven our solidarity, whether by volunteering to support our warehouse colleagues during the lockdown and standing side to side with them, to working on different roles, like our area supervisors, for example, who supported our customer service team in Dubai, and they handled KSA online orders to us, who supported them fully. Also by creating a chance for our BAs to proactively engage and contribute to a meaningful initiative, where, for example, in L'Occitane we designed an exclusive packaging for the last Saudi National Day. The artwork portrays the margin of culture elements between Provence and KSA. For this limited edition design, we wanted to empower Saudi women first and foremost to be part of this initiative, especially with the growing feminization of our staff, as I said before. This beautiful exclusive artwork has been designed by one of our artist beauty advisors from KSA. Actually, her name is Asma, and I would like to say hello to her. She always creates beautiful packaging ideas and recycles elements and give it life. All these examples are certainly a proof of our strength, whether having our people at heart, to our high level of agility, which keeps on helping us shift to modern life and believe that growth mindset is the key pillar for a stronger future.
Yeah, I fully agree with Lujain about it, because today, as a bulletproof that as lockdown were lifted, consumers have been returning to the shops. Our people were optimistic, and they wanted to go back to normality, despite the fact of there is a lot of uncertainty now. During the past months, if I want to support my saying by some numbers, during the past months, retail sales business has jumped over same period previous year by double digit versus same period previous year, and months over months we were like tripling our numbers. So I think during the pandemic and being agile and learning from what we were facing on a daily basis, we learned a lot, and we were very 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 agile in order to gain our business back to track. So back on track. So
that's great. It's actually quite exciting and reassuring to see that we've been trying to keep the momentum going. And Joseph, what about you?
After the amazing insights shared by my colleagues here, I would like to speak a little bit about e-commerce. As we all know, in the past few years, the region and the Saudi market has been witnessing a steady growth in e-commerce. Yet the weight of e-com versus the total remained insignificant or very small. With the hit of COVID and the lockdown, the demand had to shift from brick and mortar or the stores to the e-com platforms. And those who were not selling online found themselves missing the opportunity. Our group, who has already been investing heavily in digitalizing its activities and creating platforms, e-com platforms for the brands, had to further accelerate this, this direction. And we managed to open in 1 month during the lockdown around 20 platforms from A to Z, which was something that we really take pride in.
I think the learning was very big, but we have really to look into the future. I think we have to see what's next during what we should be doing during the next few months, because today everyone is uncertain. Today you hear that there is a vaccine that they have already released it, and tomorrow they were saying that the vaccine is not efficient 100%. So really we need to be on top of it, and we need to be very agile and very proactive in our approach, because confidence in retail business is very important. We have to rebuild the confidence, rebuild the confidence between the customers and the supplier. The customers and the seller. We have to rebuild confidence between ourselves as well, because today we are hesitant at all time. We're hesitant if we go out or we don't go out. If we have to take the high safety measure, or it's better to stay at home and doing all instead of taking all these measures. So as a company, really in the next few months, we have to make sure to rebuild the confidence internally and externally with ourselves and with our customers.
Yeah, I believe here that from every challenge we can see that an opportunity arises. I was talking previously about e-com, and just also to share a few numbers. We as a group, we managed to achieve in 2020 our target in e-com for 2025. So imagine, like in couple of months, we managed to achieve like the target of the next 5 years. Not only that, today the life is going hopefully back to normal. Yet the consumer is left with two options. Either they are comfortable to go to the mall and shop from the shops, or they can simply have a flawless online experience and buy their products online.
Actually, if I just made add one point, on some days we reach the same sales on e-com that we used to do in our stores. So the challenges that you were talking about, Joseph, the behavior of our shoppers is going to show our level of agility that Rabia was talking about, to build the confidence that we have made it before, and we are certain of our ability to prove that in the future.
If I may say, during this conversation, I have like pointed three points during what we were talking. Don't you think these 3 points? I want to mention it, and it's, if you can give me your as well, your input will be very good. So one of these three keys in order to succeed in our future business is like to be meaningful. To make sure that why the customers will buy from us, okay, to be meaningful for the customer. This is one of the things. The second thing I have as well wrote is, I think what makes us different, what makes us successful, is being different and being agile during this this pandemic. So this is my second point, is being different at all time, being different in the way that we plan, being different in the way that we act, we react, we learn, and then we innovate. So I think this is my second one. And the third one is being salient. When any opportunity arises, are we the first in the mind? Are we the first in the mind of our clients, of the suppliers, of everyone? So, what do you think about this three key points that I took it from our conversation? Do you think that?
Yeah, definitely. If I may jump in, Joe, I think the first point is you said
meaningful.
I believe it's about the identity and the individuality of our group. This is something that is a main criteria for any entity to continue and rise on. And that would lead me to the second point, which is transparency in a way. And being, if I go back to Muse, for example, the last launch of it is Kun al Istithna.
Be the exception.
Be the exception, yeah.
Thank you. Indeed, we are implementing these values that you have just talked about them in our real life. I'll leave the third point to Joseph to talk about.
Like as usual, Rabia wrapped it up really, really well. Thank you for leaving the third point, because this is what I want to comment on, and this is the most important. Whenever an opportunity arises, our next mission is to position ourselves as the group or the shops or the brands that people think of to be on people's top of mind. That's very important.
Thank you all for shining a light on such key messages. It's been quite insightful and enjoyable. Thank you to all of those who are tuning in with us. And please stay tuned for our upcoming Shalhoub Group podcasts that will be coming up in the next few months. And we hope to see you and connect again with you
soon.
Thank you. Thank you, Aya. Thank you, Joe. Thank you, Rajan.
Thank you, Joe.